thank you, and it's my wonderful Mandarin. Way better than I got. As we're tuning up here, let me just sort of thank you all for being here. Let me welcome you by saying boa noite. Boa noite. Good evening in Portuguese. Right? If you notice, we're dressed in tribe colors. That's not on purpose. Actually, we're supposed to be Brazil. But it just so happens that Brazil has the same colored flag as the William & Mary tribe. It's meant to be, right? It's a match made in tribe heaven. Okay, but let me go ahead and... Well, let me just thank the wonderful music we had just now from the Confucius Institute. Everyone was so fantastic. It was a shame that we couldn't sort of be here to witness and admire the music. But we're going to be doing it a little bit more raucous, so forgive us, I don't know. But anyway, well, I wanted to thank the Department of Music for helping this happen, this ensemble. And also, thank you all for being here at a time when it's sort of difficult. If it's not the easiest time, or maybe it is, to have a break. Tonight's program is basically a musical journey around Brazil. We are going to start in the Northeast with a music called forró music. It is basically country music that's played. If you go to Brazil now, in the Northeast of Brazil, you'll hear it. It's played at St. John's Day, or up to St. John's Day, which is the middle of June. So if you go now, you'll hear lots of it. It's basically dance music. And I'll say this over and over tonight, but if you feel like dancing, come on up. This is a pair dancing. You can make up the steps, or I'll show you. okay, so we'll start with the medley here.
Thank you.
This is, like I said, sort of country music and played in the countryside. But in the urban sort of centers of Brazil, other music was happening throughout the 19th and 20th centuries. And sort of an instrumental virtuosic music called choro became somewhat of a thing. Everyone was playing it, it was hip. It could also be danced to, but not quite as much. So this first tune is actually an instrumental samba, which is a dance tune, if you want to come up, called Receita de Samba. So let's take a trip to urban 19th century Rio de Janeiro. Our journey is continuing. was a dance that was super popular before the samba. It basically was another pair. It's sort of a picture, picture a saloon, an 18th century saloon, not with cowboys and sort of the our imaginary, but maybe something that looks more like a Parisian saloon in urban Brazil.
Thank you.
famous Brazilian popular songs ever. Anyone anywhere in Brazil knows the tune. I don't know why exactly. Maybe because it's beautiful. And that's enough sometimes. But it's basically about unrequited love, this song. Carinhoso, it means lovingly. So, take it away, folks. this next tune, we're going forward in time to samba, what you might hear as contemporary samba today. A rhythm called patua, which is basically an improvised style of samba that was started in about the 40s, and it still continues to this day, which is basically everyone responds with one thing, and then someone improvises verses in the middle. Sort of chorus refrain. Sort of the structure everyone's used to. This is about a mermaid. This song itself is about a... You'll forgive the sniffling, I barely have a cold. It's about a mermaid who steps onto the ocean to samba, and when she does, the ocean gets nice and calm. Serene is the word in Portuguese, but doesn't work well in English. So, let's try. You're welcome to dance, and this time for real, I mean, you could do it, don't mind, but no one did. You're certainly welcome to come up and dance if you know how to step. That's enough. So.
Thank you.
whole semester. Someone who knows not what he's doing, nor how to dance, nor how to sing, nor how to do much of anything. So, let's start. I'll start on my right and work my way through. Waverly Langston.
Yeah.
Playing Rosales. Playing mostly Cavaquinho. Naomi Feliz, who plays mostly bass, but also has a couple of them to lead at the main instrument, and then everyone else sings in class and does everything else. Rob Risque, our guitarist, our violon player. Where are you standing here? Okay, Noor Sullivan, who is not only our surdu player and other percussionist, but he also made the beautiful program that you're looking at. So, Destiny Westbrook, playing the best. Aaron Stapel, holding a cavaquinho, but mostly mandolin. And Ethan Baker, playing accordion. So most of the instruments that everyone is playing, they didn't play them before 15 weeks ago. So it's really phenomenal. These are phenomenal students and phenomenal musicians. It takes both and dedication. So one more time, round of applause for them. Since no one seems to want to dance, well, you don't have to come up yet. We're going to dance for you. The next tune, the reason is I think everyone's really shy in general. We don't like to act like we like to do things. So we wait for other people to do them first, and then we do them. Because we want to, but we're scared to be laughed at or something, right? So, whatever. Maybe that's good. Anyway, but we're ending our journey back in the northeast of Brazil with a style of samba that is less well-known, less commercial, called samba de roda. Roda in Portuguese means circle. Traditionally, you might see this in a circle, less open than this. We don't want to close off you're watching us, so you're part of our circle. But as part of our circle, you have a job to do, which is to clap. Okay? But not just clap, clapping, but clapping with us. So, let's work on our rhythm, and then we'll all join you. Alright? And after you see the dancing, you'll see how easy it is. And you are welcome to come up. I'm asking you to please come up and participate. You can do it on the floor, you can come up to the circle. Normally you would dance in the middle of the circle. Scarily in a minute. So, let's try it. When you figure it out, jump in.
Thank you.
Thank you.